Hi there, Serdar Yegulalp here from InfoWorld at IDG. Today in Smart Python, I'm going to demonstrate Python decorators, a way to transform the behavior of Python functions by wrapping them in other functions, or as we say, decorating them. Decorators give you a way to change the behaviors of functions in a centralized fashion. If you have 20 functions wrapped with a particular decorator, you can change the behavior of all of those functions at once just by changing the decorator. This is really useful in cases where, for instance, you want to make sure whole groups of functions have consistent, identical behaviors. Now, because decorators are the kinds of things better demonstrated than talked about, let's start with a few simple examples. Here we have a function that does something extremely simple. All it does is it takes in a name and prints hello using that name. Nothing special going on there. Now, let's look at the most primitive example possible of a decorator that would work with this function. A decorator is itself a function. And what it does is it takes in the function object when it's defined in your program, performs some transformation on it, and return it. A decorator function always has the function it's decorating passed to it as the first argument, in this case, func. All we're doing with this decorator is taking in the function we're decorating and returning it intact. And as you can see, the function still behaves the same exact way. Now let's look at a decorator that actually modifies the function behavior. This is where things get a little more complex. Now this new decorator does three things. First, it takes in the original function as func, again, and then generates on the fly a new function to replace it, one which wraps the old one, hence the name of the function wrapper, although the choice of name is pretty much arbitrary. Now you see how we have a call to func in the middle of wrapper? The idea there is that we're intercepting the calls to the original function, we're transforming them in some way, and then passing along the transformed calls back to the original. In this particular case, we're taking the name argument, we're adding Mr. to the front of it, and passing it along to the original sayHi function. Notice here that wrapper will take in arbitrary arguments through the star A and the double star KA arguments. Many wrapper functions do this sort of thing as a way to ensure maximum compatibility with whatever it is they're wrapping. They just want to pass the arguments along as is. Now in this case, we're really only interested in the first argument, which is A0. If we're wrapping functions where we know the arguments, we can simplify this just by using the actual argument names, and we'll see an example of that in a little bit. Also, there's nothing that says we have to modify any of the arguments. That's just one of the possibilities available to us when we use a decorator. Finally, the third thing we do, we return the new wrapper function so that it is substituted for the original. All of this, by the way, is an example of how in Python functions are first-class objects. They can be created at runtime like any other kind of object. So all we're doing here is creating at runtime one function as a substitute for another. The decorator syntax just automates this process. Now let's have a look at a concrete use case for a decorator. Let's say you have an application that works with a database and you want to automate the process of only allowing users with admin permissions to work with certain functions. Here in this example, we have a function accessDB that takes in a username, but there's no validation logic for the user in the function itself. It's all in the decorator. The decorator function takes in the username, checks it, and if it's admin, only then does it run the decorated function and return the results from it. If there's no match, it throws a custom exception. At bottom, when we run the function against multiple names, you'll see that only admin runs successfully. Again, the key thing here is how all the validation logic is in the decorator, not the function itself. If we have 100 functions that need custom validation logic like this, then we can just push them all off into a decorator and there have this single central place to handle it and to make it a syntactically elegant way to allow our functions to use it. We could have, for instance, a validation function in line at the beginning of every single one of those functions, but that generates a lot of boilerplate. It looks ugly. It gets cluttered. Finally, decorators can be nested. In this example here, we have two decorators, one that transforms a name into uppercase, and another that adds Mr. before it. In the first example, it performs upcase first and then adds Mr. In the second example, adds Mr. first and then performs upcase. You'll notice that the order of the behavior is the same as the order that decorators appear in. The topmost decorator is the outermost wrapper, the one below it, the next outermost, and so on until we get to the creamy function center within. The important thing to understand is that each wrapped function is itself just another function, so we can wrap them indefinitely as long as we make sure that we're still passing the arguments along consistently from one to the next. That's it for this overview of decorators. If you liked it, leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to the IDG Tech Talk channel on YouTube. And for more Smart Python, follow us on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.